this is the place where it started, but it's the place also where I've had my roughest years, and it's been a real challenge sometimes to just spend time in here. But now I think I've made peace with it, and now I fully enjoy this room. This is my room.
Welcome.
This is my bedroom, my makeup studio, everything in one place. This is my parents' house, and I still live here. So this is the place where I spend most of the time.
What did you do before makeup?
I was a professional dancer, ballroom dancer. I went to the tryout, and they immediately said to me that, yeah, you're the one, we want you, we want to like go to the professional like league or something, and we want to achieve a lot. And I was in high school, and I thought that okay, but it's like a really big commitment for me to go back to dancing. But I decided that yeah, that's the thing I want to do, and I went back. And it was really successful. I won like Estonian championships. I won like big world cups, let's say. And the world ranking in under 21, I was 10th place. And there was like, I don't know, 900 couples or something. So I was like, okay, I know how to dance. Like, it's impressive. I'm in a like warm place. It's like a home to me because I spent a lot of time in this hall. Like every day after school, I would come here. I would spend like hours in here. Sometimes I'd do like my schoolwork, like sitting one of those chairs, and I don't know. I just spent a lot of time in here, and I think these were like one of the best times of my life. Yeah, I think it's one of the hardest sports there is, because you have to train like your whole body has to be like in a perfect condition all the time, and you're dancing five dances at a time. One dance is like 2 minutes. You have to, it feels like you're running 100 meters, but in 2 minutes, then you have like 15 to 20 second pause, and then you have to do it again because another dance starts. So it's quite difficult, yeah. It it was just like a random Tuesday, and I was dancing, and I just suddenly felt like really, really like bad pain on my right hip. And I, at the beginning, I thought that, well, when you're an athlete or you're a dancer, you get injured all the time, and most of the things just fade away or like go away by themselves. But this one, it stuck with me. But then I had to have hip surgery, and I had to quit dancing. I had my first surgery. Nothing really helped. I had my second one. Nothing really helped. Nothing got better. And I was stuck into my bed. I couldn't go anywhere. I was just told to lay. You cannot walk, you cannot sit, you cannot do anything. I think I walked with like crutches for 3-4 months. I had to learn how to walk again properly after that, even though I was supposed to walk with them for only like 2 weeks, but I felt like my body wasn't recovering at all. It was mentally a very hard period of my life to find the strength to like wake up in a good mood and like find something to do with my day, because most of the days I was just laying down and I don't know, watching like some stupid YouTube videos or something, because I just couldn't do anything. And even if I wanted to, like, okay, I'm gonna be productive, I'm gonna study, it was still like, but like, why? I chose to not share what I'm going through with my friends or anything, because there was one specific person who like got mad at me or like pulled me down, because he told me that it was too hard for him that I was sick or that I was feeling this way. And after that, I was like afraid, because I thought that everybody would just get tired of me or like something like that. So I decided that I wouldn't share and I would just do it by myself. I think my best support is, for sure, I have two best friends. They're always there for me, and my boyfriend, and of course my little dog. I don't know how animals do it. Like every night when I feel like, for example, I don't know, my back is hurting, I might like a lot, and I'm just sleeping, and then he comes and he like rolls around and finally like settles down like that she's fully like covering the part that I have the pain in. So I don't know how he does it, but it's really comforting for me. But yeah, after coronavirus came and everything just went down, and I decided that maybe it's time to move on and do something else with my life. And well, I found this makeup thing for me actually because of coronavirus came. So everything just lined up, and I decided to take a next step in my life. I feel like it's looking really crazy right now, but it's always like that in the beginning. I feel like makeup is my main hobby right now. It's my work, it's my passion. But I was always the girl that never wore makeup. I would go to the party and I didn't even put mascara on or anything. But I always had like the passion for arts or some kind of form of arts. And I didn't know what it was, because I'm not like super good at drawing or painting. I just had a lot of free time, and I was thinking like, yeah, why not? All of my friends know how to do makeup, and I wanna be able to do that as well. And then I just tried, and I found that I'm good at it.
I wanna do like an online course. I feel like I might have a chance to succeed with it, because this kind of makeup, nobody does, nobody teaches it.
I think the studio is my first step. I think one day it would be awesome to like open like a big salon or something, and take other like talented, I feel like young makeup artists that are like me today, but to give them like a good place to start their journey. Because for me it was like, it was really difficult at the beginning. So I would love to help like the young ones.
I know the first step seems scary, and you might feel like, oh, but I don't have all of these things, and like I just have like some the cheapest stuff that you can get from the grocery store, or that's not enough, or I'm too afraid to share my work with my friends on like social media or something. But you just have to start somewhere, because I also had the cheapest things from the grocery store at the beginning, and I was also afraid to share my pictures. I was like, why would I post a selfie on a store on my Instagram story, because it's just like cringe. The best advice is just to start, like, don't like think about it that much, just start somewhere.